It is Sunday night, and we are live in the Madhouse Studios with the Maverick Soul Hour, and I am Tommy Maher, your host, and boy, oh boy, great show tonight. Great, great show, and it's a special show because it's a very, very dear friend and someone that means a great deal to us. So, but I'm going to hold that for a little bit now. Don't all you people upstate get pissed off now. Just hang in there, hang in there. I do have to talk a little bit about a couple things coming up. First of all, I want to let you guys know about something that we're going to be doing on May 28th, Saturday, in Washington Square Park. And if you're anything like me and you think that we live in a world that needs a change and we need to stop the hate and maybe have a little more peace in this world, this is something for you. It's time that the sheeple stop being herded by the bad shepherds and do something good and show up for this thing. It's going to be called Blues for Peace. No better way to get to people than through music. And this is going to be an awesome event. It's May 28th. It's at Washington Square Park from 1 to 5. Michael Packer, he's the head of the Blues Hall of Fame in New York and New Jersey, who I got to thank last week on my show. I had Michael Packer, Joe Louis Walker, and Eddie Jackson. Three Hall of Famers in the studio with me, well, not Mother's Day, the week before, and they were absolutely incredible. I can't tell you how good these guys are. And now this Blues for Peace at Washington Square, it's free. Right in Greenwich Village, come down. Free, the word free. Come down, support the world by showing your face and supporting peace. It's going to be a rally that's going to be unbelievable. They're actually doing it in at least seven or ten countries throughout the world, and it's something that is so needed with all this hatred going on. I don't get it. How, you know, life is such a speck in time. It's just, you're 70, like that. And why waste it hating and racism and bigotry and the whole thing, chopping heads off. It's time that the sheeple have to make the difference. It's really, we've been led by the wrong people. And it's time to educate the people as far as sharing some love and some kindness out there rather than hate. So come to Washington Square Park, May 28th, Saturday, 1 to 5, free. Did I say free? Free. And you're going to see Hall of Fame artists performing for you live with a great vibe. Hopefully there's going to be a lot of great people there for the right reason. For the right reason. So please, please, please come down and see us. I will be emceeing it. So it's going to be great. I hope all my Woodstock people come. Come on down. Come on down. Come say hello. All right. Also, Mousetrap Cafe. News. Coming along, we're really, really, really close. And I know, and trust me, people, if it was up to us, we would have been open 2 months ago. If you ever could dream of politics that would drive you crazy about opening up a restaurant, let me tell you something. You'll go in an insane asylum. But the place is looking incredible. The stage, we brought in an artist that is doing this mural on the back of the stage by hand. Incredible. You gotta see this place. Stay tuned. Please, please, please go on Facebook. Go to the Mousetrap Cafe. Like us. Just hit the like and you're in. Follow where we are at. Yesterday I put up a flag on the flagpole on the roof. The bar is beautiful. The stage is coming along. The floors are coming out. Everything, all the units are in behind the kitchen, behind the bar. The kitchen is ready. We're waiting for some rugs. We're getting the windows tinted. We're just doing the finished touches. Got to do a lot of artwork and put some stuff up there, but we're really, really close. Hoping the beginning of June we're going to be open. So the Mousetrap Cafe in Amityville, New York, right in the heart of the town, one of the most beautiful towns on Long Island, without a doubt. It's a beautiful setting right in the back door. Parking for like 200 cars. We're 1/10 of a mile from the Long Island Railroad, so you can come in from the city. 1/10 of a mile, you're there. Beautiful. So, the Mousetrap Cafe. Hit it and like it, and that will be the place to be. I can tell you that. All right, listen. We're going to take a break. When we come back, I'm going to introduce you to a very dear friend of mine that will not only blow you away as far as a human being, but as an artist, she will blow you away. And there's so much to talk about with her because her life has been like an incredible deal. I mean, you got to take the trip. We're going to do a This Is Your Life. Maybe we'll get her to cry. Right, Jonathan? All right. We'll be right back with the Maverick Soul Hour. Get yourself right. Get yourself tight. We'll be right back. And I'm telling you right now, you're going to enjoy this one. Hang in there. We'll be right back.
Galaxy Luxury Coach is a full-service limousine and party bus company. Family-owned and operated, we are an industry leader with over 25 years of experience in providing best-in-class luxury transportation for your special event. Whether it's your precious wedding day, an all-day wine tour out east, your high school prom, that special birthday, or just an amazing night on the town, our professional chauffeurs stand ready to ensure your special event is truly special. Galaxy Luxury Coach has one of the largest and modern party bus fleets in the New York area. Our party buses are simply nightclubs on wheels, concert sound systems, light shows, lasers and strobes, multicolor LED lighting brilliantly lights your party bus inside and out. For corporate and more laid-back events, we will cater to your specific needs and requests. What sets Galaxy aside from all others in the luxury transportation industry is our attention to detail in customizing our services to your special event. At Galaxy, it's all about you and your guests. Galaxy customers return time and time again because they know they can trust Galaxy to help deliver those lifetime memorable moments. Step aboard and let your Galaxy experience begin.
Hello, I'm Dr. G. I've established an organization called Voices for Veterans. We use music to honor veterans and to help the public understand what veterans have gone through when they come home from war. On October 22nd of this year, we're going to have an incredible show, a 3.5-hour concert at Molloy College, one of the greatest 500-seat theaters on Long Island. We're going to honor 25 veterans. We've taken an incredible band, 15 people from Long Island, some of the best musicians we could find, and we merged it with a 30-person choir, merging gospel with rock and roll. This incredible 3.5-hour show is like none other that you've ever seen. This is Grammy quality. October 22nd, you can buy a ticket, you can make a donation, you can get involved, you can help us with the committee. You can look us up at v4veterans.org and go on our website and get all the information about the show. Please make a difference to these veterans by coming aboard with us with Voices for Veterans. Thank you so much.
We are back in the madhouse with the Maverick Soul Hour, and I am Tommy Maher, your host. And ladies and gentlemen, I want to introduce a dear, dear friend of mine. that we adore, and we often go and see her upstate, Mrs. Patti Greco Sunshine. And believe me, that's her real name, because I didn't even believe that, but that is it. How are you, my dear?
Hello. I'm so happy to be here.
It is so good to have you here.
I'm thrilled.
It's great. It's great. Nothing better than be with great friends. Nothing better. I just want to let, you know, I just want to start this show off by telling the people at home that, number one, she is an incredible artist. She has played, which we'll get into later. I don't want to get into all the depth of her musical career right away. I want to take a little turn and we're going to kind of go backwards. Is that okay with you?
Yeah.
Can we go backwards?
Yeah.
Because, first of all, I have to tell a quick story, and probably the only person that really could appreciate this story is Jonathan Sunshine, because one time, first of all, Patti lives up right by the original Woodstock site up in Bethel, and she had a restaurant on White Lake, on the lake. And Janine, anybody that knows Janine, she has to get all of her, necklaces and bracelets and hippie clothes and all that stuff. So we found this little tiny boutique next to this restaurant on the lake. And we went to the store, and we walked in the store, and we had been in there before, but we never met Patti or Jonathan. And we're walking around, and it's not a big store. It's like a size of a big walk-in closet, But the coolest stuff you'll ever see. And even as a man, I mean, I'm like, this is Janine. This is outrageous. This is outrageous, outrageous. You know, stuff you can't buy anywhere else. So I'm really being interrupted by the vocals in the background here. I'll tell you that. So we're in the store, and I'm like, wait a minute. There's nobody here. I mean, you can see. Hello. Nobody comes out. So I'm like, this is weird. Now I'm thinking, we're going to get arrested. And I can't even explain. I'm sitting there, and I'm like, there's really nobody here. This is odd. So I said, let me go outside. I go outside. I walk next door. There's a restaurant next door, and I'm walking. There's nobody there. So then I see this guy in the back, and I'm like, excuse me, is anybody at the store next door? He goes, no, it's closed. Now it's closed. I said,
Mr. Personnel.
Pardon, but we're in there shopping. He goes, no, you're not. Yes, we are. He goes, no, it's impossible. It's locked. It's closed. I go, well, my girlfriend's in and out. I'm just letting you know, if anything's missing, it wasn't us. So he goes, nope. He comes walking out, and we walk in next door, and there's Janine in there shopping away, and he's like, I can't believe it. So that was my first meeting with Jonathan, who is one of my, he can hang out with me any day, anytime. I love that guy, which is Patti's husband. A really great guy, a regular guy, very rare nowadays. You know, the handshake is good. So then time went on, and we always kept missing you. Every time we were there, you were never there. You had that little lady there. And Janine fell in love with the store, and then we found out that you moved. And so then we actually, the first time that we met was at your store.
Yep.
And now you had moved to Monticello.
Right.
So we pull in, and we have talked on the internet. But
yeah,
we
connected right after that on the internet, but never met.
Right, because you thanked us for not robbing your store.
Yes, that was very nice of you.
I was going to get a truck and back up, but, you know. We went up, we do our trip up to Yazgers, and so we go up and we go into the store, and we finally get to meet face to face.
It was like meeting my brother.
Yeah, it was great. Yeah. It was instant bond. I got to tell you, though, the store, like, it was like, you know, like kind of how I want my bedroom, you know what I mean? It's like very hip, very, very rare pieces, very... I guess like a dream of Jeannie's lamp kind of place, you know?
Yeah.
Just comfortable. She had a big couch in there.
You want to read your tarot cards.
Yeah. But it had that, you know, it was just a beautiful place. Janine went berserk. I know, we spent, I don't know how much money in there. But, you know, Patti and I sat down on the couch and we were talking, and she had a 12-string guitar. And so she came out and we started singing. I think you sang House of the Rising Sun.
I did, for you. It was one of I had just learned it.
Right, right. Yeah. And you just started really playing guitar too.
Yeah, like 2 months before.
And amazingly, and starting on a 12-string too.
Yeah.
And
more of a reason to hit a note, you know. Yeah, I got a better shot.
Right, right. But it was, we were just all, I think, all so comfortable with each other too.
It was
like I knew you for 50 years,
yeah.
You know. And so since then, of course, we've been going there often and often and often, many times, and spending tons of money.
It sounds like I'm expensive.
No. We couldn't go up there that much if it was tons of money. I'll get into that though too. But what I want to say is that I'm even though I dearly love her, it's really not. I'm not here to do a commercial for her. I'm here to do a commercial for you people, because anybody that knows me, the items that she has in her stores. You can't find them. You women, forget about it. The men, you know, she has more women stuff.
I really try.
She gets me a lot of stuff.
Difficult to find.
Stage clothes and stuff.
Yeah.
But the women, berserk. Yeah, there's some pictures. It's a beautiful, beautiful place. But I got to tell you, we talk all the time. I mean, we've stayed at her house. I mean, she has a gorgeous, her house is like going to heaven. And Jonathan's, not just her house, Jonathan's too. And
we love our house.
It's like when you drive down the street to get to a house, it's like, oh, what is this? What is this? And all of a sudden you come into this paradise, you know? And it's just.
Yeah.
Zen.
Heaven on earth for us.
Zen.
Yeah.
And we should give a shout out to Paul and Linda too.
Yes, we had such a great time when they visited.
Hey, guys, what's happening? And Lissandra, too.
Oh, there we are. Yeah.
Yeah, there we are.
Yeah.
And we had a beautiful day that day. Jonathan is a chef. He made us a great dinner. I'm getting off track of the store, but that's okay. This is friends talking. So, but what I want to press to the people at home is that I know how women are. I do. I know how they shop. I know how they like to find things that no one else has. This is the place to do that. And you might say, well, God, they're up in Bethel or Monticello or wherever. But what Patti does is if you go to her, the name of the store is the Funky Hippie Chick Boutique, okay? Now, if you go to Facebook and friend like the page, it's a like page.
Yep, the Funky Hippie Chick
Boutique. All you got to do is like it.
Yep.
And she puts a video out how often?
I do a daily vlog.
Right.
Where I dress up in the clothing.
And it's so cool. Well, first of all, she's such a beautiful woman anyway. But she comes out and she'll show you exactly how to wear it, how many ways you can wear it, because I watched them all.
There you go.
I mean, that thing that you were tying this way, that way, that way, and every way looked good.
It's fun.
It's amazing. But you got to see the pieces that she has, not just clothing, jewelry, bracelets, you know. Well, there you go. There you go. Mm-hmm. Can we get a shot of her, Janine, doing her?
Jewelry, mud cloth, clothing.
Woo-hoo. There you go. Look at
that. Sleeves. Got to have sleeves.
And that's something that you could purchase.
That's a signature thing. I love
that. I love that dress. It's absolutely beautiful.
Yep.
Beautiful. But so now you can click on, go on the page, and this is from my heart and soul. I would not lie to you. I have called her because it's the easiest. She has made my life so easy.
Oh, yes.
Because anything, Christmas, everything, birthdays, anything with Janine, Patti, hello, yeah.
What's she going to like?
What's my limit? Okay, this is it. Go. And, and she'll come back right away. How about this, and then I'll pick. This, and I'll pick. And before I know it, but the best
Janine
part is she'll hang up the phone with me, and the next morning, that stuff's on my porch. And that's great. But the great part about your store is that you do the videos. I think that is the greatest, smartest thing.
Yeah.
It's just that we got to let the people know that
they need
the access to it.
Yes, and that would be on my YouTube channel, which is Patti Greco Sunshine.
Patti Greco Sunshine. And now you can go and watch it. I mean, you'll see
dress.
All the new pieces come in. She'll show you how to wear them. She does a video. I'm telling you, you ladies are going to go crazy. But trust me. Because I know a lot of people are afraid to shop over the phone and
we'll make sure you look good in it.
No problem if
picture.
It doesn't. Yeah, yeah.
Send me a picture
Call
of
her.
Yourself. Call me.
She'll talk to you on the phone
absolutely.
Right in the store and tell you she is so good.
We'll get you out of your comfort zone.
It's like having a professional person dressing you. Really.
Yeah.
It is. And
it's
great.
That.
And like I said, the best part about it is you're going to find things that you're not going to find anywhere. Anywhere. Anywhere.
Thank
and that goes for all the singers I know and everything. This is the place to be. I know now Janine will be like, now everybody's going to have to say
that. I know, but that's how I feel.
That's cool.
You know, sometimes, you know, if I'm doing a show and,
right.
Well, actually, I think you guys came up to see me at the villa and Janine and I were wearing the same necklace.
Right.
I was on the stage.
Right.
She was in the audience. It right. was great, but I knew she was going to wear it. That's why I did. I did it so we could be sisters. But I don't get more than, I usually get no more than two of the same item. Sometimes only one.
Right.
But no more than two because I want women to be individual. And for them to have, you know, an opportunity. It might be a wrap skirt, but yours is this color combination, this is that one. And of course, whatever you pair it with is going to be your own unique style.
Right.
What do you have
well,
in your closet?
I can only tell you, because, I mean, we go to many shows. We're in the city a lot. We're backstage a lot at a million things. And the women go crazy when they see her stuff. I mean, where did you get that? Where'd you get that? Where'd you get that? Where'd you get that?
It's
and we
how
tell
they
everybody.
Wear it. It's
we
how they wear
everybody.
It, though. It's how Janine carries it. You know, it's knowing the right thing for you.
But that's what I'm saying.
Yeah.
You can direct them into
love
the
it.
Right place.
Love that.
You know? So
yeah, love doing that.
That's her bag. That's
yeah.
her bag.
My bag.
So do that. I'm telling you. I mean, Ginny, do we have any more pictures of the boutique? Oh, you did go through them all? Okay, good. See how I pay attention? All right. So the hippie chick.
Chic.
Chic.
Chic. Funky, hippie, chic, boutique.
See, I always say chick.
I know, because I'm the funky hippie chick.
That's right.
That's why they call me the funky hippie chick.
Right.
But it's a funky hippie chic.
And while we're on the subject, the reason, the way you came up with this concept was when you were doing the cruise ships and traveling the world, right?
Yes, yes. Let me tell
you. And you see, I'm a funky dresser too.
Yeah.
So I know what you're talking about. And so tell the story.
So what happened was, you know, I worked, I was blessed to be on the cruise ships for like 30 weeks a year for about 10 years. And when I started, you know, the thing about me is like, I'm going on a cruise, what do I wear? And the first thing I thought was, Bermuda shorts? Really? Really? and I was like, that's not who I am, I can't do it. So long skirts, cool, flowing, easy. So I became the Carmen Miranda. Basically, I'm walking around in a long skirt. I had a beautiful belly at the time, got my little top, kind of like this, but I used to bare the belly in those days. And a hat. Big old hat like this, you know, I look like all I needed was the fruit. So this was my style. I became like this, you know, whatever country we went to, I looked like I belonged there. So, and of course, as we went to different countries and I got to adopt their style, I began to realize that this is a mud cloth that I'm wearing. You find something and you incorporate it. And I found that this was what I wanted to be. And every time I'd walk around the ship, the passengers would go, oh, I love that. And they start calling anything like oh, I got a Patti blouse. I got a Patti blouse. So I started realizing.
Well, we called
realizing,
them Stevies.
And you call, but see, that was crazy because
right, when, before then.
When I was doing this, it was in the 80s, okay, and I wasn't ever really in the rock genre, so I wasn't aware of that. And that was more like gothic.
Mm-hmm.
But I started like I was known for my sleeves. And then I think Alicia Keys started doing the sleeves, and people who knew me would say, oh, yeah, that's like Patti Greco sleeves. But it became a style that I had, the long skirts, the lots of ethnic jewelry, and sleeves.
Right.
So I started just finding stuff. And then people would say, you know, you should open a boutique. You should open a boutique. And that's kind of how it evolved. And then when I was lucky to marry my husband, who had a restaurant, we said, you know what we need in front of this restaurant? We need a little boutique, like a Cracker Barrel thing. You know, let's just do that. So that's when we said, you know, let's just... It was so little, like
yeah.
you said, it was just a little porch that we
yeah.
enclosed. And I started with just jewelry and dashikis and just, I wanted ethnic. I wanted it to be a trip around the world, which
right.
is what we call the funky hippie chic boutique, a trip around the world. And
it is.
And that's basically what the concept is. Now, an interesting thing is when people think of hippie and hippie clothing, it's really a trip around the world. I mean, the dashiki was worn because it, you know, it was worn by Richie Haven. Why it was African clothing.
I wear them on stage.
Right? So it was people don't realize that the hippie era was because people were worldly.
Right.
And they were traveling the world, right, and getting beads that they were wearing, and they were coconut shells, belts, and things like that. And that's what kind of did it.
Mm-hmm.
And for me, I probably think that I was from Egypt in a past life.
But see, well, I have a page, the Woodstock Guru page, and I put up a picture the day before yesterday of a little girl that just, and don't be afraid to be different. Be afraid to be the same as everyone else.
Oh, yes.
So, that I've always been that way. Yes. I mean, even since I was a young 12, 13 even. Yeah. I never wanted to look like everybody else.
Absolutely.
I never did.
Well, let me ask you something, because that brings me to this interesting point. You know, I was raised by a single mom, and we were poor, like a lot of us were. You know, everybody was basically poor.
So we were too.
We were poor. And so clothing, everybody had the newest jeans. I think it was Lee jeans and work boots. And, I couldn't afford that. So I would get hand-me-downs. And what I did with the hand-me-downs is I cut them up and I'd redo them. So I remember going to school, like in sixth grade, in like crushed velvet hot pants, having the teacher go, "Hey, you look nice." I mean, because I had a way of dressing, and I was painfully shy. That was the interesting thing. Nobody who believes that. But I was painfully shy. Anybody who knows me from school knows that I was painfully shy. In my painful shyness, my boldest colors, the boldest clothes, it was like, yeah, look at me, but don't talk to me because I'm a little bit, I'm a little bit shy. And that's how, when you can't afford clothes, you become, my mom used to make me my clothes.
Well, let me ask some.
Yeah.
Because I know how I, and even when I was in the construction business in New York, I always was like, every other person that was in a suit in construction, they looked like clones. The only thing difference, maybe the color of the ties.
Right.
They all had the same khaki pants and geeky jacket. And I always said, they all called me Hollywood. And that's for 35 years, that was my name in New York.
Yeah.
But were you aware that people, and I guess it's the hate thing, I guess, I don't think hate is really the word. It's like, I think it's people that really want to be like that, that can't be like that.
They're afraid,
or don't have the balls
to be
like that.
It's kind of like, it's kind of like, and I never
thought
of it.
I remember walking in, I won't tell you the name of the building, but it was on Wall Street. And I remember I had to go to a meeting, and I'm never late. I hate people that are late.
I'm usually about 5 minutes late.
I'm never late. I'm never late. But I was running late. The subway got stuck, and I was late. And I came into this meeting, and it was like the table had to be about 30 feet long, and it must have been 20 guys around this table. And I just, looked. And I'm, pressed out, but not looking like them.
Right.
And they just looked like clones.
Right.
And this is when it all happened with me. And I'll get back to the question I wanted to ask you, but I remember walking in, and I could hear the mutters, not the fathers, the mutters. No, I could hear the muttering under the breath, and it pissed me off. And these are like all these big, and I remember sitting down, and I could hear, and I could see these like couple guys like laughing, and I just said, I just stood up, and I said, "Excuse me. If any one of you people in here think for one second that I would ever have the ambition to look like any one of you," "you are absolutely losing your mind. If you don't like the way I look, I really don't care.
You like
I choose
it.
Not to look like you guys."
Yeah.
"Because other than the colors of your tie, you all look like clones." So,
That's
I was wondering if you were conscious of it, even though.
Very conscious.
Yeah, me too.
Because.
But I kind of liked it.
And what's funny about that story is that three young girls came into the boutique one day. Three young girls, like 20-somethings. And they're all wearing leggings, black leggings, little short boots, beige top, all of them, with a cowl thing around the neck.
Mm-hmm.
So I walked in, and I can't help myself. And I look, and I say, "Okay, so is this a uniform? Are you guys in a club?
Are you in the Brownies?
What's the, because it's like a uniform." Right. They weren't even aware that they were actually wearing a uniform. There's part A, part B, part C, and you sort of get to make garanimals or whatever. And I'm thinking, I was always so I remember getting dressed and saying to my mom, I could have the wackiest things on. I'd look like I was in a costume. In fact, I usually looked like I was in a costume. Kids would come up to me and say, "Ma, can I put a costume on? Because she's got one on." That's how I always looked. But it wasn't, to me, I just really loved funky and layering and all that stuff. So I took those three girls and I said, honeys, don't you want to be individual? Don't you kind of want to just look like you? And I took them apart. You know, I made them and I dressed them up and I you know, it wasn't going to stick, you know, because if it's your mind, if it's your mindset that that's how you want to dress, it doesn't work for everybody.
Right. And a lot of people won't do it because of the shyness or they're afraid to be
someone
bold.
Someone will tell them because that's another thing someone said to me. Girls come in, they love what they look like, and then their friends see them and go, what are you wearing? And they're like, well, I really thought it looked good. It does look good. It looks good.
Yeah, that's right.
And they don't want to tell you it looks
the
good.
Haters.
Because you look good.
Right.
You look good. And I don't know, you know, to me, what I love about the clothing in our boutique is we're not talking about showing a lot of TNA.
Right.
No, it's not form-fitting. It's figure friendly.
Right.
Whether it's a wrap, because they're wrap dresses, wrap shirts.
That one video I remember distinctly you must have did 10 different things with this
thing.
And
you want, because the bottom line is a woman wants to feel beautiful. You don't want to show off what you don't have working. You want to show off what's working. So
leave some mystery.
Leave some mystery for guys. Exactly. And the beautiful thing is when a man sees you wearing a dress with long sleeves down to the floor and looks at you and says, oh, you look beautiful. How cool is that?
Yeah.
How cool is that? You're not looking at her tushy hanging out.
And the ones that are wearing the Daisy Dukes and that, all the guys are really doing is, wow. And then, you know, they're not thinking
flat.
You as a,
you know.
As a, you know, you're kind of like a slutty thing. You
it's
know?
Wonderful when, what I love is women come back in the store and they go, I wore that dress. I got, people just couldn't, my friend Pat, absolutely. She wore something that she got from the boutique, and she texted me and said, I'm getting tired of people telling me how great I look here, you know, because she kept getting compliments about how she was looking.
I believe it, because, I mean, I see it. I see
Isn't
it
that
with the stuff that Janine wears. I mean,
and it's my pleasure. To me, that is like, because I'm not the kind of woman who's, you know, a lot of women are jealous of other people. That's not me. I want you to be the best that you can be. I want to help you do it. Yeah. I'm going to help you do it. And I'm not going to have you walking out of there with your tushy hanging out.
Well, a perfect example is when we were up by you and we went to your show. And just by coincidence, a lot of my friends were up there.
Right.
And you even said, I don't think they'll...
That's not for that. And, I didn't think they'd like the stuff.
And they came
That's
in
right.
and blew out the store, right?
They did. But you know what people always ask me? Are you going to be honest with me? I said, you bet you.
Yeah.
Because I don't want you walking out of here and not looking good. And if it doesn't
no,
look good,
I know you as a person, and I know you wouldn't do that.
Yeah, because you know, that's the biggest thing.
A greedy salesperson couldn't care less
that's
once they're out
thing.
The door. Because these will come back. You know, that person won't come back.
Absolutely. So. For me, it's all about showing a woman, even if she says, but I really like this. I said, yeah, but you know, it doesn't do anything for your
I've
figure.
Seen you. I've seen you work. I've seen you work.
Yeah, I love it. I mean, to me, that's...
And you could see that, too.
I do.
I could see that you do.
I do love
it. You know, like a lot of people probably hate their, you know, but you love what you do.
And you know, it's really kind of crazy, though, because I spent all my whole life being individual. You know, my mom used to make my gowns for stage, and I'd go up on stage, and people, where'd you get your gown? I'm the only one who has it. My mom made it. I'm an individual. And now I'm selling these clothes that I wear, so I'm almost sharing my look.
Right.
So it's almost like it's tough sometimes. Because
but you've established your staple, so you're all right.
I kind of there are some things that I save just for me. Like they'll say, well, I want that. I'm like, I mean, I can give you stuff.
I understand that.
But I can't get, because, you know.
I'm like that.
Yeah, and then sometimes, you know.
Like guys say, where'd you get that?
You don't want to tell them. And that's why, like, Janine, I understand what Janine's saying. She's saying, oh, I don't know about my store. That's my store. And
I know.
I get it, and that's okay.
And I understand that, too.
I totally do. Which is why I have a friend in California buys for me all the time, and she never plugs the boutique. And I say, Clay, you know, and she says, and I know why. I said, it's okay. You just put it there. I know where you got it. I'll say great top. But I get the idea that women do want to keep their secret, and that's okay. That's okay. That's the reason I only get two of this, two of that,
Of this. That's actually a good thing.
Oh. Absolutely.
Because that is showing you want to be that individual. You
want to be, and I want you to be.
Yeah.
So, yes, it's. I
so
love it.
So let me ask you a question, because I'm not sure about this, but I, being that we are live all over the world right now, and we do have a massive audience in England, Norway, Australia.
How do I ship to these places? That's what I want to know.
Well, that's the thing. I mean, Anybody can tell me how to do it.
Because, you know, I really have a hard time with that because of the cost factor. Mm-hmm. So if you're buying $100 worth of item, but it's costing you $70 to get it to you.
Yeah, but see, a person that's what I mean. Yeah. Your store, you have things that they can't get anywhere.
I would
pay the extra $70. I mean, it wouldn't bother. Yeah. I would love to do that.
And the only thing I can say is that if they're willing to pay the... they're willing to pay the shipping, I am willing to give you a discount.
Right.
Because, you know what I mean? Because right. I get it. So I am willing to give you a discount if I'm doing that because I understand how much.
Because I can already see the English girl, the yeah. girls in
yeah.
England.
Oh, Australia. I guess.
Where is that place? People. Where is that? You know?
Yeah, and it's great. And if you, anybody who can email me a way to do it or who to ship, what venue to ship through, I'd be happy to know that because I have no problem.
Yeah,
doing
I did want to just say that because I'm sure there's going to be a lot of people that are very interested in your store.
And it's also, you know, a lot of times, like you say, it's very individual. You know, I think a lot of it is the way it's put together too, because you might go to a festival and see similar items.
Right.
But what's really cool is I would walk into my guy that I buy from, and I'll walk in wearing my outfit, and you know what? He looks at me like he's never seen it before. I bought it from him,
right.
And he'll look at me and go, well, that's an interesting way to do it. Or, wow. And I'm showing them how to wear their clothes.
Right.
Because a lot of times, it's you can't, you know when you look at a magazine, you go, ugh,
yeah.
I don't like that. And then I say, you know what? That's a terrible picture. That doesn't make that look good. I would never buy those pants if I saw that picture. But then I see the pants because I see it and I go, ah, I got a vision. And then you put it with the right belt, with the right shoes, with the right top, with the right jewelry. And now all of a sudden, you go, that's why the vlogs work. The vlogs work, you know, the video daily dress, because I show them what it looks like on.
I can't really say it enough.
Yeah.
To go on and see it,
right.
Because trust me, if you see it, it's a whole different ballgame. It's not like going into Macy's or something. You know, don't sue me, Macy's. But it's, I mean, you have a professional person dressing you.
Yeah, I love it. No, to me, it's fun. To me, it's like, you know, who knew? Who knew in my later life that I would be a fashionista?
I do want to get into what you do too, but one last question. Now, what was I going to just say? I had a great question for you. Oh, can we talk about the new venture, or is that something
yes,
we should
please.
Wait about?
No.
Oh, please.
We actually had the foundation.
What you're doing.
Okay, so what I decided was, you know, we said that we first had the little store by the restaurant, and then we evolved to a store that I rent in Monticello. Well, you know, then the cool thing that happened is, in our hometown, we now have a casino coming, the Montrain Casino and Resort, and water park and all that stuff. Well, it happens to be across the street from my house. Well, howdy doody. I mean, there are things that are going to change in my life, but the one thing that was important, I said, well, this is an opportunity here, and I'd have to be crazy not to put my store there on my property where I don't ever have to leave my earth, because I love my earth.
So we're
building the store, not a big store, 28 by 36. It's going to be, we just put the
who else could build a store and have people every day come by the busloads?
Well, that's what I'm so thrilled about. I mean,
that's a win-win, boy.
And the cool thing is, they're putting a sidewalk right in front of the road. We'll have a sidewalk right in front of my store. So the store is going to have a nice a nice concrete floor that we just dyed Sedona color. So it looks like the earth.
I actually
it looks
was
like
thinking
the very
about
earth.
Doing that in the cafe, but
so it's really cool. And they did that. Walls should be going up next week. And if I'm lucky, by June 15th, I'm lucky, we'll be in. And I can't wait because it's going to have a little rocking chair porch. I plan on just expanding not just jewelry and clothing, but expanding more to things that you would have, gift items, things for the home, all keeping with a trip around the world, you know.
And probably... you'll be out in the porch playing a
guitar.
Playing
my guitar, absolutely. That's one thing. If you come into the boutique and you're in there looking, I go, hey, you don't mind. You know, and I pick up my, you know, and I play them a couple of tunes so you get a little entertainment while you're waiting. And, it was my way of, that's how I learned guitar. I was sitting in the boutique and I said, you know, when you're a multitasker, I'm a multitasker. So I can't, like, just do one thing. So I said, you know, I'll learn the guitar. And that's how I did it.
You learned very quick. I mean, that was when I first met you, was really, you just started.
Yeah.
And you even, I remember saying, I don't know if I can even get through this song, but,
yeah.
you know, and then I saw you, what, a couple months later on stage and you were killing it.
I had the balls to do it. Who has the balls? You know, that's the thing about, you know, a lot of people.
If you don't have the balls, you'll never do it.
That's the thing. I am not, you know, there are things I'm a perfectionist about, as you know. There are things I'm a perfectionist about. But then there are things that I just believe that, you know what? If you don't jump in, you ain't never going to do it. And if you wait till you're perfect at something, it'll never happen.
So, they're on to the next thing anyway.
So I picked up the guitar and I said, you know, I'm gonna play it. And I just started doing it. And if I missed a chord, I sang. Yeah. I was singing. So it's not like I'm not competing to be a great guitar player.
Right.
But the beautiful thing about accompanying myself now in my show, the little segment that I accompany myself, is the freedom of being able to do it how I want it in that moment.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's not like you have it. I mean, you have an arranger written and you know how it goes. But the beautiful part is that when you control that and you want to slow this down now and you want to get this here now, you have the opportunity to do that. It's all up to you. If you screw up, guess what? It's also up to you to get out of it.
Right.
Whereas you don't have to tell the band to vamp because you just missed your cue. You got it.
Right.
So it's fun. I mean, to me, Tommy, it's therapy. I said, on my porch.
I see.
It's therapy.
And I've seen your show a few times, and I mean, I like the way you fit it into the show. You know,
it brings it down.
And
you know,
and well, let's get into that. Let's get into. Let's move off the. Go shopping. Now we're going to go into. Now we're going to talk about some serious business. Not that that's not serious, but the reason that I think that we probably connected is because we're both singers. And we had a lot in common, and we liked the same kind of things, and we've done a couple things together.
Yes.
And so let's go back. You started singing, what, age 8?
Yeah.
Age 8. So take me through that a little bit.
You
know, where were you at? What was going on? How did it, what, I like to find out what keyed you to say, I want to sing, you know?
I was raised in an entertainment family, and that my father was a performer, played every instrument. He was a singer, comedian, MC. He was one of the first tumblers, one of the last tumblers in the Catskill Mountains, the Catskill Mountains heyday. And the tumbler was the guy who kept the audience entertained,
right,
whether before the act, after the act, in between the act. And if the act didn't show, guess
like
what?
Like I remember that guy at the, what was the... Gross singers that used to do the
Simon Says. Yes.
He used to be on Mike Douglas all the time.
Right. And so the tumbler was the guy who, the singer didn't show up, open the show with some songs, the comedian didn't show, we're going to do some songs. So that was my dad, very talented guy. But my parents were divorced when I was young, and so I really didn't get to really partake in that life with him. However, it was in me. And so I was singing time I could talk, I was just musical as far as just being verbal.
Mm-hmm.
And I think when I was blessed to, when I was 8 years old, I started going to the city for about 4 weeks every summer with my aunt person, not real aunt, Joanne Florio. And Joanne Florio was one of the Catskill Mountain acts. And she was a cross between Mae West and Pearl Bailey. Okay, she was kind of like...
I thought you were going to say Sophie Tucker.
Yeah, well... Okay, Sophie Tucker was in there too, absolutely. I mean, she had the boobies up front, you know, one of the jokes was, this is my husband, well, but never mind. Anyways, the big boobies and big voice, huge voice. And she was scary. She was that, you know, that scary buxom blonde,
mm-hmm,
gorgeous. She'd take me every summer for 4 weeks from the time I was 8 years old, and she would teach me a lot of things. It wasn't just about voice.
Right.
It was about my fingernails with I was
shopping,
biting them. It was, you know what I mean? She would have a way of just, she was grooming me.
Was this in Manhattan or
yes,
Brooklyn?
Yes, in Manhattan.
In fact,
she made me learn the song for the address. 246 West End Avenue, apartment 7A, in case I got lost.
That's probably worth a gazillion dollars now.
Right? Isn't that wild? I had to learn that so if I ever got lost.
That was very smart.
Right, wasn't it?
Very smart.
So that was my intro to, she'd make me hold a note and walk around the apartment. And she had a pretty big apartment. So she'd just say, Patti, hold a note. And she wouldn't let me stop until she told me to stop. And that's how she taught me how to hold a note. It was an interesting way of learning. She wasn't a real vocal teacher. She was a performer who, you know, watching someone do a show is one thing. Watching the rehearsal is another, right? Don't you think? Don't you love watching a rehearsal? I love the rehearsal.
I'd rather watch the
Show me the rehearsal. Because I want to see what makes them work, what are they thinking of? And I would watch the rehearsals, and I'd see how she treated the musicians. I'd see how things were done. I would then watch the show and say, oop, they didn't do that the way they planned it. Ooh, that didn't work. Because you learn how to fly by the seat of your pants, and after watching every single show, in the Catskills, we got to see everybody, everybody, the best. So you really, you know, were privy to seeing great people work. And I think that's probably, it was always in me to do that.
That was kind of implanted in you.
That was implanted. And it wasn't until, I think, I was singing at 8, and I remember losing a contest when I was 10, the Mousy Madness contest. It was a Mousy Madness
night.
Never
forgot that one.
Never forget. And I was crying like a baby because I lost.
Yeah.
And my father says, Patti, he took me aside, you know, it was my first, like, I lost. I was really good, you know. I was better than her. He said, Patti, she was 18. You were 10.
Yeah.
You know what they're thinking about an 18-year-old? You know what they're thinking about it? He gave me the lesson. Patti, you're 10.
Yeah.
They're not booking you.
Well,
they're going to book the 18-year-old.
It wouldn't be good
to
start off winning anyway every time.
No, and he taught me. He says, you got to just let it be. Just keep doing your thing. So, you know, I think that when you learn to, like you said, to take the hits and don't think you're all that. And my mother was not easy. In other words, if I'm singing and that sounded like crap, I'd hear her from the other room. What the heck? What the heck? You know, she didn't cut me any slack. She never walked around and said, oh, my daughter's great. My daughter's best. No, she kept telling me, you better, because that 14-year-old's going to kick your butt.
Right.
And so I learned always to strive, always to respect other musicians, always to know, you know, when you sit in with a band, know your key, know your tempo. You know, all those things that you can only learn from really good musicians.
Okay,
you know?
So now, when...
There's
when,
so much.
When,
I can't, yeah.
Now, I know you ended up in Texas, right?
Yeah, I was supposed to get married.
So...
Didn't happen.
Did you have a career before the Texas?
Yes, that's when I was at the Concord. I started singing at the Concord when I was probably about 17.
All right, let me stop you there, because, I mean... I have to say this because I think it's very important. I mean, first of all, let me just run through a couple things because it's important. I mean, you played Atlantic City, you played the Showboat, you headlined there at Harrah's and Bally's and Resorts, and you did the cruise lines. You portrayed Liza Minnelli, Connie Francis. You've always done a one-woman show, but... And then, you know, the old Catskill hotels, the Concord, the Raleigh, the Pines, the Neverly, the Fallsview, Browns, which Jeanine and I almost bought a condo there.
Jonathan used to be the manager at Browns.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
And, of course, Villa Roma, which we've seen you there many times, and which is a great place to see an act. But now here's some of the people that you opened for. I just want the people at home to hear this. Marvin Hamlick. Gabe Kaplan, the Gatlin brothers, Pat Cooper, who has got to be one of the funniest people.
I know him. He used to come to the house. He was my father's friend.
Bada bing, bada bing. Red Buttons, Norm Crosby.
Love Red Buttons.
Dahmer.
Gabe Kaplan?
No, we said him. Jack Carter, Nipsey Russell. Nipsey Russell.
Also a family friend, Nipsey Russell.
Jan Murray, Freddie Roman, Steve Lawrence, Stephen Eady. I mean, it goes on and on.
Yep.
So, but now tell me, where did, was that before the Texas trip?
No, that was Texas.
Texas.
A lot of it was Texas, yeah. Well, what happened was, it's interesting how it happened. So I was basically lounge singing at the Concord, basically sitting in with the bands and doing my lounge singing. And then, in fact, I was supposed to be... a lounge singer at Grossinger's, and my mother wouldn't let me take the job. I was 17. She wouldn't let me take the job because she wanted me to go to college. And I studied electron microscopy in college, which was like, why? Yeah. So,
what is that?
Yeah. It's a study of the electron microscope, and the reason I studied it is because I could pronounce it. Okay, but electron microscopy was, you know, looking at a microscope all day, like real exciting to me, you know, like I'm a people person, you know. Oh, that pancreas is stunning, you know. You know
what I mean? That cell.
You know what I mean? It just wasn't for me. So I was flunking out, and the I had to go in front of the board because I was flunking out. They said, what do you want to do? I said, I want to sing. They said, so go, sing. So that's how, you know, I basically did the three-year school, you know, the two-year right. school for 3 years, and right. I dropped out. But when I didn't take the gig at Grossinger's, my mother always knew that that was probably a mistake. I probably should have done that. But it's okay. 22 years old, moved to Texas. I was supposed to get married. I moved to Texas. Somehow I fell into these bands. It was a line. It's called a line of bullshit. I believe in knowing how to do that. How to, you know, learn how right. to, the art of bullshit. So I get to. I wanted a gig. I get to Houston, and I auditioned with this piano player. And he said, "Well, you know, who are you?" I said, "I'm Patti Greco from New York." Now he doesn't know I'm from a little town in New York. He said, "No, I'm from New York." Oh, from New York. And all I had to do was sing for him. I sang for him. He was hooked. We worked together beautifully. And next thing you know, he says, I got the Patti Greco account. I got the Patti. Who the hell's Patti Greco? Oh, you know, from New York. It was all a line of poop.
Yes.
So I get to Florida. I'm in Texas. That one gig led to another. Next thing you know, I'm singing with the 16-piece orchestra, the Ed Gerlach Orchestra. And it's great. I mean, I'm working with the best musicians possible. I fell into this, you know, fairly easily. I always feel a little guilty because, you know, there are people who work hard and practice. And I always say I was blessed. It was just being heard by the right person. And maybe that's not a big thing to sing with right. a big band, but to me it was.
Yes,
to me it was huge to sing with these guys. So after...
Like I always want to have a gospel choir behind me.
You know, the feeling of that behind you, yeah. and they're good, you know, nothing like it. So when I got, when I was pretty much felt like I didn't want to be a wallflower anymore on a big band, that's when I came back to the Catskills. But on the way back to the Catskills, I stopped in Florida to visit my sister. So I stopped in Florida. While I'm there, might as well call an agent. So I call an agent. Now I'm 24, 25 now. No, maybe I'm 26, okay? So I call an agent. I send him the only videotape I ever had because I had sung at Gilly's in Pasadena, Texas.
And they weren't a big thing then either.
No. And I had done a talent contest. And I won the talent contest. So here I was singing the sweetest thing at Gilly's. And I used that as my promo. So the agent saw it. He says, great. He says, when are you available for booking? I said, I'm available for it. He says, do you have charts? I said, of course I have charts. I didn't have anything. He says, you got patter? Of course I have patter. I didn't have anything. So I go home. It's a Monday. I get a phone call from him. He says, Patti, you're booked Wednesday at the Wynmore. Now, Wynmore was one of the – it's still there in Florida. It's a big club, mm-hmm. a big facility. Yeah. I'm booked Wednesday. Oh, my gosh. Now, what am I going to do?
Okay. Where are these charts?
I got no charts. yeah. I got nothing. I have two charts. I had New York that was written for me when I was 16. And I have my father's opening number, Special Day, which was one of his charts, and we sang in the same key. So I got an opener, and I got a closer. And I got no middle, and I got 45 minutes. Okay, now what comes in is my memories of Joanne Florio. So I'm booked for the show. I got to do it. So I say to the band, okay, I'll tell you what. This crowd's a lot older than when I used to. So we're not going to use my charts. I'll tell you what. We'll use my opener, and we'll use my closer. But as far as the rest, we're just going to fake it. You know, Bye Bye Blackbird? Okay, good. We're going to do it in B-flat. You know, The Way You Were? Yeah, we're going to do that in G. You know, and I basically threw together the middle of a show.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know how, as far as patter, what? So I thought, what would Joanne say now? What would Joanne do now? And basically, I was just pulling from all the people I had seen.
Right.
Did my show. I get a standing ovation. It's my first show ever. One-woman show. Oh, my gosh. Agent calls, oh, my God, you killed it. Great. We're getting booked. And that was the beginning. Now I had to first get charts. So I got my charts and started building my chart repertoire. And again, I'm telling you, I was blessed. Again, I fell into a situation where someone wanted to get off the cruise ships, happened to call my friend Lenny. Shout out to Lenny. My friend Lenny. And said, you know anybody that wants to take my job? I've been on the cruise ship for 9 months. I got to get off.
Mm-hmm.
I'm in the production show. I got to get off. I'm out of here. And he said, Patti, you want to do it? I said, mm-hmm. Just happened to be doing a show at a place called Christine Lee's in Florida. So I call up the agent, the dance company, and I say, well, you know, and again, art of bullshit, very cash. You know, I'm on the seat of, I got no money. I'm broke. And I'm on this. Now, before that happened, because I just missed a really important spot. I get a call from an agent asking me if I want to go on the cruise ships. And I say to her, sure. She says, well, it only pays, and she gives me like this much money. And I did my homework. And you know, you always have to do your homework and find out what the going rate is. Don't go in cheap.
Right.
So I find out that she's cutting me. I said, come on, man.
Welcome to the music business.
Yeah, I said, come on, man. I said, you know what the going rate is. That's not enough. She goes, well, you've never been on a ship before. It's your first time. You're going to hone your act. I said, I don't need to hone my act. I was like really ballsy little kid. I mean, I didn't know what I was doing, but I had to believe in myself. So she said, well, let me see what I could do. Hangs up the phone, calls back, $250 more. Still not there. I say, you know what? You know what the going rate is. I'm not going out in cheap. So no, you'll never work a cruise ship. You'll never work, blah, blah, blah. After she turns me down, tells me I'll never work, that's when I get the phone call from Lenny. It's magic. It's like, what? Who did this? It's a miracle. Mm-hmm. I go, I show up. Miller Reisch was the production company. They come, they watch my rehearsal. I had never heard my charts before. Now, you know what that's like? In fact, I'm going to be doing that opening number. I never heard the chart before. Didn't even know how it sounded. Got a band I never met before.
Right.
And I'm auditioning.
And usually from all over
and
the
I'm
world,
auditioning, right?
Right?
So there's the band. Here's my chart I never heard. Kick it off. I start to sing. After my first song, she stops me, calls me over, says, here's the contract. 6 months on Carnival. There's the money I want. Exactly. No agent. So there's the money. I signed up. Of course, I crossed out the line that said I had to do cruise duties. No. I crossed that line. And I signed up. And that's what started me on cruise ships. So I was on Carnival for 6 month run, 3 month extension. And at that point, that's when I really, for the first time, did my show. I was full of bull.
Yeah.
I had never really done it. But I said, you know what? It's kind of like when someone throws you in the water.
If you didn't do it, you wouldn't be here.
If someone throws you in the water, what are you going to do?
Right.
You got to swim. That's it. You got to swim. So that's kind of what I did. Next thing you know, that agent who told me I'd never work a cruise ship calls me Patty Darling.
Oh, yeah.
Patty Darling, I got this for you. I got that for you. And she became my agent for the rest of my
really?
Cruises.
Really? You let her back in, huh?
I did, but I raised my price. You know, but it's called believing in yourself and not selling out, you know, just because you think you want a break. You got to, it's a gamble, man. Yeah. I took a gamble with that, but.
What do you got to lose?
I had nothing, and you know what? Blessing it was, like I said, I was completely blessed, and that took me to the cruise ship.
No, but that's actually a good lesson for young artists coming up. I mean, don't, because they are taking advantage.
Absolutely.
I mean, you can read, the history goes on and on of the ripoffs that these guys that we grew up with, they were just totally ripped off.
They just
off.
Wanted to do it.
Yeah, because they, and, you know, I'll sign anything. Yeah, I got a contract. Yeah, I'll sign it.
And also, so. You want to be able to, you know, when I worked in Atlantic City, and how I got there was also because, you know, my agent says, you're never going to work Atlantic City. They only want name acts. You're never going to work Vegas. They only want name acts. So I go myself. My mom and I got in the car. We drive to Atlantic City. That's what we did. That's how I got my gig in Atlantic City. Mm-hmm. I drove to Atlantic City. And I was, again, it was a blessing. You know, Sal Richards, I don't know if you know Sal Richards, wonderful comedian. Sal Richards happened to be playing there. I asked him if he knew an agent. He said, yeah, I do. In fact, he's over there. I talked to the agent. I said, hey, you want to walk my VCR? You want to walk this upstairs for me? I want to work here. And I'm wearing my black leather pants. He looked mm-hmm. at me and goes, yeah, okay. And he walked it upstairs. Hour later, comes down and says, what do you think of the room? And this was Resorts. Mm-hmm. When it was Merv Griffin's
Resort. It was the first casino
Resort.
I ever went to.
Really? And that was it. I was in the lounge.
It was only two then.
It was.
When
this,
I went.
When you went. But you know what? This was when Resorts was.
When it just opened. It was Resorts
fantastic.
And I forget what the other one was. There was only
Paris?
Two.
No,
there was
that's
only
on the
two
side.
That were open.
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah, no, this was a strip. But that was it. You know, you have to believe in yourself enough to take that gamble yourself. But yeah. That was then. Tommy, that was then, and that was
yeah,
a good
well,
life.
Well, I
and
want
I'm,
the people to
and I'm blessed, you know,
take the journey, I'm, you know,
yeah,
what, you
I'm
know,
blessed. I
think I like to know how they got to where they got to. I mean, so
I was
want
lucky.
To let the people
I was lucky,
know.
And you know what? It's a passion to sing, but it's more of a passion to have a life.
Oh, yeah.
You know what I mean?
Oh, without a doubt. We
to,
know that.
To
now.
Have a life that I have now, which is.
You got a good life.
Which is I get to sing a couple of times. I love to sing, and I still do it. So I do it, you know,
and even
a couple times a month
when,
I'm
when
doing
that.
When
you get to an age where you don't feel like doing it, you go down in your studio in your basement. Oh,
like we did.
And we
had
sing.
Such a good time.
That was fun. That was
wasn't
fun.
It?
That was fun.
Oh, we call it the basement sessions.
That was fun. That was fun. I can't
we
wait to do that again.
We got to do that again.
Yeah, that was fun. All right. So now, okay. Now what's going on now is you are still performing in a lot of theaters and a lot of casinos. And
I don't do casinos anymore, not at this point.
You will be, though.
I mean, listen, I don't...
I know a place this, close by.
Yes, well, I'm hoping to get into there. That would be good, right across the street. That would be perfect.
How good would that be?
You know, it's I pick and choose the venues now because I don't actively pursue it. I'm so in love with this boutique, you know, and so in love with that idea. And if someone, if you want me for an occasion, love to do that. I would love to do your party or your wedding or your special day or, you know, or occasional dinner theater kind of thing. I would love
to do
something
like
that.
Well, you're going to do the Mousetrap. We know that.
Because that's going to be, you're going to find me a good piano player? You're going to find me a good piano player?
Don't worry about it.
Yeah, give me a good one. Give me someone who likes to, who could sing every song. You know what the thing is? Let them teach me some songs. Oh, because I know every song is ever written.
I already got a girl.
One.
It's a girl. She's phenomenal.
I think I did see her on one of your shows. Yeah. Oh yes. I need a someone who can elevate.
Yeah.
Because that's what you want. Someone who.
No,
can
you would be great. I can't wait to have you in there. I can't. Now, you've also done Good Morning America.
That was from the Concord Lounge. That was crazy.
Oh really?
Yes.
That's cool.
That was from the Concord Lounge.
That's a big thing for a girl upstate, right?
They were filming at the Concord, and I was, again, I'm telling you, Tommy, it was an accident.
You know what's really cool, though, like in your childhood, how you got to see these legends and talk with them and be over your house for dinner and stuff. I mean, who haven't you seen?
You know, Pat Cooper, when I was little, when I was like three, my sister was beautiful, blonde, blue-eyed child, and I was the one who looked like the ad for Care. You know, I really did. I was like, picture the shirt with the sleeve, hanging off, and I was really not smiling much, and I was very, very dark, you know, because I was always a sun in the sun. I looked like I was dirty. My grandfather used to say I looked like, because I was probably playing in the dirt if I knew me.
And still play in the dirt.
I still love to play in the dirt. I do. That's right. And Pat Cooper sat next to me and said, you know what? Because everybody thought my sister was there. She's the beautiful one. And he said, you know what? You're going to surprise him. You're going to surprise him one day. And he's the one. So you know how cool it was when I got to open for Pat? It was like opening for Pat Cooper was like, how cool is that? He knew me and he believed that I was going to be something. He didn't know what. But he knew I'd do something.
He's great.
Yeah.
Red
Buttons was also one of my very favorites. Loved him.
Yeah.
Yes. He gave me some very good advice. I used to have this big fake ring that I wore on my hand, big diamond, fake, but it looked fabulous. It looked real. It was like 28 carats. He said, lose the ring. I said, why? He says, you're pissing off every woman in that audience, you know? And that was the truth. He said, lose it, you know? And, so you always have to listen to someone who's telling you, someone like him who's telling you, you know, it's nice when someone thinks enough for you to tell you something that's going to help you.
Right.
Because most people don't want to tell you something that's going to help you.
Right.
You know, why? They're the headliner.
Well, that's a person that's not threatened, and, you know, they like you, and you could tell, you know, that they really, truly do care
about
you.
And they want you to be better.
You know, what I can't stand in this business is when you do reach out to help someone, and they shortly forget who you were.
Oh, yes. That happened to me many times.
Whoa. Let me tell you something, boy. I could go on and on.
So could I, my darling. I think about it all the time. All the people that I gave my agent their name, because I thought they were fantastic.
Yeah.
And I gave them their name, and then they don't even remember me, but then there are the ones who do. And the ones who do know who they are.
Oh, yeah.
And you know what? It's nice that they remember
absolutely
that you gave them that opening.
And why wouldn't you, you know?
Hey, they ran
with
it.
I guess we were just raised differently, I guess. I don't know. But I know a lot of people that I know that I've helped.
You got to know, you know, I always say, you know, they always say that you meet the same people on the way up that you do
got that right.
on the way down. And when you're way
right.
down, you better hope that they got you. Otherwise, whoops, sorry, didn't see you. You know what I mean?
Right?
Yeah. No
like
question.
That agent, she wouldn't have got a second chance.
Yeah, you know what? It turned out.
It ended up good.
Yeah.
So I see you got a guitar over there.
Uh-huh. I didn't bring the 12 string today because I haven't been playing that long,
yeah.
right? So because I haven't been playing that long, when it comes time to changing a chord, changing a string, I put them on backwards. I do, because I'm a lefty. Yeah. I'm a lefty. I play a right-handed
guitar. Jimi Hendrix.
But I play a right-handed guitar, but I put the strings on backwards, so my G string.
Right.
My G string was busted.
That Jonathan.
So, speaking of my little guitar, you know what? Interesting thing happened. I was sitting on my porch about 3 months after I learned how to play. Since I was 3 months after I was noodling. And my father used to always have a guitar in his hand. And I remember that. We got to know each other when I was in my 20s. Mm-hmm. And so he'd sit and always had the guitar. Cup of coffee, cigarette, and guitar. And this is one of the songs that we used to sing together. And I'm sitting there on the porch, and all of a sudden, I swear, Tommy, the chords are coming to me. Now, I don't know how to play guitar. So I'm thinking, how do I even know this chord, that chord? I don't know. I don't even know what the chord is. What am I doing? It just sort of came to me, and it was his song. And I think that that was a sign for my father saying, you know what? Pick up the tradition and pick up that guitar, and it'll bring you joy. And it has brought me incredible joy. You want to hear that song?
I certainly do.
I gave it a 50s thing. Why not? I'm lonely, and I'm thinking of you. I'm wishing that my dream would come true. Each night I pray your mind to take. Then I find you gone when I awake. A dream that fades as soon as night is through. I'm dreaming you're near me. You didn't say that mess up, right, did you? And that feeling is spring. I'm hoping love finds me, and my heart wants to sing. Oh, 'cause my dream is just a fantasy that never will come true. Or maybe I can find someone like you. I'll find someone like you. I'll find someone like you.
Very nice.
So that just came to me, that song. It was kind of like what it was. Anything else?
This is your gig.
It's my gig. Think Janine will cry if I do that song for her? You think she will?
We won't hear her.
Janine! You know, I had a blessing. My dad was the entertainer in the family, but my mom raised me. And, you know, this goes out to all the mommies out there, because without the love and support, well, it's a mommy song or it's a daddy song. Depends. You could do it whichever way you want.
Well, I was a mommy and a daddy.
You were very blessed.
Because I had to raise my kids by myself.
See? So you were both.
I was. Matter of fact, my friend called me for Mother's Day and said, Happy Mother's Day.
See?
And he was the same. And when we did it, it was very rare, you know, because the fathers didn't get custody,
right.
You know?
Mr. Mom.
That was my license plate at the time.
Really?
Yeah.
So in that case, we're going to do this as a different song for you then. Baby, there's a tear falling from your eyes. You know when I'm around, you ain't supposed to cry. But when you feel uptight, I'm there to make it right. Let Papa know. On a cloudy day, when you're all alone, I'm only gonna be as far 'cause your number's on the wall. Don't be afraid to call. Let Papa know. Let me be the one that turns you on to sunshine. If anybody ever brings you down, when you need love, count on me, I'll always be around. If this crazy world ever gets in your way, I'm gonna turn the earth around and whip you up a brand new day. 'Cause when it comes to you, there's nothing I won't do. Let Papa know. Let me be the one that turns you on to sunshine. If anybody ever brings you down, when you need love and understanding, count on me, I'll always be around. Oh, if this crazy, crazy, crazy world gonna turn the earth around, and I'm gonna whip you up a brand new day. When it comes to you, there's nothing I won't do. Let Papa know. Let Papa know. And let your mind.
That was beautiful.
Yeah.
Beautiful.
That's a song I thought I wrote.
Huh?
That's a song I thought I wrote. You know what I mean? I didn't write. No, no.
Oh, I
did. That's a saying. That's a saying, you know, when you think, when it's really something that you really believe, that's a song I thought I wrote.
Well, you do that in your show too, right?
Yeah.
With what song is it that you say, this is a song that I wrote?
You're talking about this one. You're talking about my relationship with John Denver.
Yes, that's it.
Not everybody knows that I had a relationship with John Denver,
yeah.
You know? You know I'm obsessed with two things, right? John Denver and the Titanic. So John and I were sitting around, and he wrote...
That's John Denver now.
Oh, of course, John. We call him John. I call him John. And we were sitting around doing this song, you know, because I was there when he wrote it, of course.
Of course.
Yeah.
Rocky Mountain.
It's been around a long time, this song. And I said, you know, John... I called him John. You don't mind if I change the lyric a little, do you? And, of course, he said Patti. He called me Patti. No, go ahead. I said, because, you know, there's a certain part in that lyric, and, you know, I'm all about lyrics, and if I can't believe it, I can't sing it. So I don't hope you don't mind. He said, no, go ahead. So you might notice the part that I changed. You might not. All my bags are packed, ready to go. Standing here outside your door. I hate to wake you up to say goodbye, but the dawn is breaking. It's early morn. The taxi's waiting. He's blowing his horn. Already I'm so lonesome I could cry. So kiss me and smile for me. Hold me like you'll never let me go. 'Cause I am leaving on a jet plane, and I don't know when I'll be back again. Oh, babe, I hate to go. So many times you let me down. So many times you played around. I know you told me they didn't mean a thing. But every place I go, I always think of you. And every song I sing for you. When I like you never let me go. Cause I am leaving on a jet plane, and I don't know when I'll be back again. Oh, babe, I hate to go. Now the time has come to leave you. One more time, just let me kiss you and close your eyes. I'll be on my way. We're gonna dream about those days to come when I won't have to leave alone. About that time, I won't have to say, oh, kiss me and smile for me. Tell me that you'll wait for me. Hold me like you'll never let me go. On a jet plane, and I don't know when I'll be back again. Oh, babe, I hate to go.
Beautiful, beautiful. I just want to let the people at home know that actually that was kind of improv, and she's singing through just a lav. So I don't know what it sounded like out there, but it wasn't, you know, I mean, it sounded great here. But I don't know, because we never really did that through a lav.
No, we didn't.
Whatever it was, it was. But now, before we break, and because Patti's going to go up and do a whole set with a whole orchestra. So before we do that, though, tell the people how to get a hold of you, or if anybody wants to book you or whatever, because when you hit that stage, you're going to get a lot of phone calls. So.
Oof. Well, you can go to my website, www, which my friend Pat says I don't have to say, but nonetheless, www.pattygrecosunshine.com. That's Patti with an I. Greco with one C. Sunshine, as you know it. .com.
Great name. Great name.
I like it. I got it. And I got it honestly. It's not because I look like Pocahontas.
I never
believed
that until I had both of you together.
I know. I know. And of course, the Funky Hippie Chic Boutique is just www.funkyhippiechicboutique.com.
And Facebook?
Facebook is the Funky Hippie Chic Boutique. I had to put the
go there, hit a like, and you women are going to go ballistic. Trust me on that.
Call me up.
And
we'll
even
dress
the guys.
You. We'll
I mean, you know,
up.
The guys, she has cool stuff, really cool stuff.
Speaking of which, cool stuff. Okay, Tommy, this is from the Funky Hippie Chic Boutique, and I want you to have this because, you know, Tommy looks really great in all his scarves. He's a big scarf guy. This is a mud cloth, and this is from Africa.
Cool.
And I just picked this out for you. I thought this is our little tag here. I ripped off the price.
Maybe I'll wear that at the Blues for Peace.
But I love that.
Thank you so much.
That is for you.
Beautiful.
That is for
you.
So much. And this right here is for Janine. Janine, darling, I got you this, okay? I think you're going to love this, okay? Because I know you wear all these fabulous necklaces that you got from the Funky Hippie Chic Boutique over here. And they look great on you. And this is like, will hang right over here under your boobies. It'll look really good. It'll be, and it's peace, man. It's peace.
Yeah, we'll
hippie
that,
chicks.
We'll wear that next week at the Peace Rally.
That's it. Yeah.
All right. So, is there anything that we're not, that you need to get out?
Oh, my gosh. Is there anything I need to get out?
Yeah.
I need therapy? No, I don't need I love, I know, no, I've gotten everything out. I have a garden, and I'm hoping things are growing. Do you like gardens?
I garden like crazy. I'm crazy.
Are you really?
I'm a nut.
No kidding.
You know what my favorite thing about gardening is?
What?
Watering.
Really?
I
doesn't it make
just
you feel
go
like
outside.
You
gotta
pee? No.
And I just, everything just.
Really?
Moves. And I just, and always, I still drink out of the hose.
Yeah, yeah.
I love drinking out of the hose. And I don't even like water, but I drink out of the hose because it brings me back to my childhood.
Yeah.
And
I
you know, I even do this stuff, you know?
Yeah. You know, we used to do that.
The pistols, I break them left and right, but I just sit there and I'll just water. And it's just like therapy for me.
It is therapy. And
it.
Playing in the dirt.
Yeah.
See, I got my nails painted blue because guess what?
I know.
You know, it's like, I mean, a girl's got to do what a girl's got to do.
That,
you know,
I dig that.
I love digging it. And I know I should wear gloves.
Right.
But, you know, I'm not that way. I got to get in there.
Life's too short
gotta
to worry
get in
about
there.
Stuff like that.
Yes, I'm hoping it.
So when you see Patti at the big venues and she has the brown fingernails, you know what it
That's
is.
That's it. It's just, it's not that you know, they're dirty. It's, yeah, it's the, just, you know, it's Mother
it's
Earth.
Love. It's
Mother
love.
Mother Earth.
It's mm-hmm. love. Mm-hmm. Love of vegetables. So then Jonathan cooks them anyway.
Oh,
so,
my gosh. You know. He's
great.
He can't
cook.
Wait for his radishes to come up.
I love radishes.
Yeah,
I
so does he. He loves radishes. Yeah. So we gotta. Yeah.
Well, Jonathan, get ready. Let me know what's on the menu because we'll be up there shortly.
Yeah,
and
my husband
we really
can
can't
cook.
Wait to see you, too. I just want to give him a shout out.
Yeah, my honey.
Because I really, really love him. I do. He's a great
me
guy.
Me, too.
Great guy.
I'm lucky.
He is my kind of guy.
And that's the thing.
Not many of them around anymore.
That's the thing. I waited till I was older to get married, you know, I was single.
Over 20,
and, you know, I'm almost 30 now, so, you know, so, you know, I waited, and I picked the right guy. I didn't actually pick him.
Well, I got to say, as an outsider looking in, you guys have a beautiful life. You really do, and you're really blessed.
I know,
and
I know.
You know when it's fake, and you know when it's real. I mean, even for him, like, the reason he's not
tough.
Here...
Yeah.
It's because he just loves his home so much.
Yes.
And the dog.
Our Zoe.
Our four-legged
little girl.
The coolest dog.
Yeah,
really.
So he's like, I got to stay home with the kid.
He's probably eating the screen right now, right?
Zoe, if you know, Zoe's like a cat, you know.
But it's crazy. Like, we're sitting in your den watching and every commercial.
Oh, she loves television.
The dog goes berserk.
She's
berserk.
Crazy for the television.
It's crazy.
Yeah,
it's,
I know.
And if there's another dog on
forget about it. Yeah.
But I'm wondering... Her watching you now.
Oh, that would be cool.
We gotta find out.
I wanna know what she thinks of that. Hey, Zoe.
Thanks, Jonathan. Let's find out what's going on with the dog.
Wait, you want some chicken? No, Jonathan makes her chicken. Makes her own chicken.
I've seen it.
Yeah, hers, and she's addicted. It's like crack. And now I got my friend Patricia's dog on the crack. The dog eat crack now. It's chicken. But anyway, you know, you gotta spoil them. They're your kids. Yeah.
All right, well, listen. Are we good?
We're good. I talk too much.
No. This is your life.
You're my bud.
This
my
is
brother.
Your life. And I'm glad that I'm just thrilled that you're here, and I'm glad that the world's going to get a chance to see you sing.
You know,
no,
I love it. You know.
No, but I am really happy about this. So
thank
we're going to take a little split. We're going to come back, and when we come back, Miss Patti will be on that stage over there with a live orchestra behind her.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Wow.
Yeah.
You guys are good.
Yes, we
spared nothing.
Nothing. We had them busted and everything. But hang in there, keep yourself tight, get yourself right, and we're going to be back with one of my best friends singing right up there on that stage, and I am very proud to have her here at the Madhouse Studios, because I'm thinking Mousetrap, Madhouse.
Beautiful studio. Can I just say a little plug for this place? This place is gorgeous. Very nice. You could live here. Well, you could, but you shouldn't, because, you know, they clean up underneath you. But I'm telling you, it's a beautiful place. Everywhere you look is a beautiful set. I mean, I feel like I've arrived.
You have.
I have arrived.
You have. All right. So hang in there. We're going to be back in a couple seconds with the beautiful Miss Patti Greco Sunshine. So hang in there. We'll be right back.
Welcome to the Funky Hippie Chic Boutique. Today, I'm going to take you around the store. So we just walked in, and what most people do is they sign the book, say hello, give us your email so we can keep in touch. This is our nice little section. We're sitting and relaxing. If you want to shop, you shop. If your hubby wants to sit, please do. Then we can chat, see what's what, you know, play a little music. That's what we do here. There's a couple of signature outfits right there. Okay. Oh, what do we got here? We've got some men's clothing over here, some beautiful tops. And we've got some jewelry, some nice earrings, very unique earrings. Okay. And now we're coming around to the counter. Oh, there's my girl. This is the counter. We've got some more jewelry here. OK. Okay, that's Veronica. She's my sales girl. She doesn't really talk much, I gotta tell you. Okay, we come around here. Got another nice outfit. Got a nice display of jewelry. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. Got some incense. And we've got this beautiful hand-dipped incense there. And our spectacular jewelry. Now, you've got to find something you love in there, I'm sure. Okay, now we come to the clothing. Beautiful clothing, fabulous scarves. This is the part that you usually see when I'm doing the videos. Okay. Back of the couch, we've got some really nice coats. Lots of bags. We've got candles, hats. We've got mukluks. Very nice. Nice man dressed very nicely, I must say. Dressing room. This is our dressing room. We take a peek into the dressing room. Woo-hoo. And these are our tchotchkes, as I call them. The hand journals. Interesting. Little animals from Indonesia. Put a little picture in those. Those are really cool. Oh, groovy, man. Groovy. And now this is my room that has, I call this the Casablanca room. Moroccan pottery, some nice tapestries. Larry's, this is Larry's. Oh, he is an unbelievable artist. Gotta have a Larry, everybody should have a Larry. Again, some beautiful pottery, tagines and such. You gotta come visit us at the Funky Hippie Chic Boutique for sure. If you haven't been here yet, you've got to come and say hello. I want to thank you for joining us, and we will see you soon. You know where to visit us, www.funkyhippiechicboutique.com. Hello, and welcome to the Funky Hippie Chic Boutique. I thought today I would take you through our store and look at the jewelry a little closer up. Isn't that a gorgeous piece? This is some of the pieces that we have here. And then there's a little pouch that I made. I think it really goes nicely with that whole ensemble that she's wearing, don't you think? Then you get a closer look here. We've got some beautiful pieces hanging. A lot of turquoise. Turquoise is in, and this is these are African Indian style necklaces, all with influences from Nepal and India and Africa. All work so beautifully with our clothing. Of course, our scarves and our skirts and our bags and our ponchos and, oh, really nice outfits here. And of course, belts. I mean, it's always good to have a nice belt. Okay, now I want to take you around to our showcase because we've got some really beautiful stuff here. So this is our line of jewelry from Egypt, and it is pewter with silver on top. It's absolutely beautiful pieces. Some of them are from India. That jeweled piece is from India. But the styles are just dramatic and fabulous, aren't they? Oh, and you can't just have one. No, no, no. They each have their own personality. Don't you think? Oh, love, love, love. So please visit us at www.funkyhippiechicboutique.com and see if you can make one of these fabulous pieces yours. Have a great day. Hello, and welcome to the Funky Hippie Chic Boutique.
Hello, I'm Dr. G. I've established an organization called Voices for Veterans. We use music to honor veterans and to help the public understand what veterans have gone through when they come home from war. On October 22nd of this year, we're going to have an incredible show, a 3.5-hour concert at Molloy College, one of the greatest 500-seat theaters on Long Island. We're going to honor 25 veterans. We've taken an incredible band, 15 people from Long Island, some of the best musicians we could find, and we merged it with a 30-person choir, merging gospel with rock and roll. This incredible 3.5-hour show is like none other that you've ever seen. This is Grammy quality. October 22nd, you can buy a ticket, you can make a donation, you can get involved, you can help us with the committee. You can look us up at v4veterans.org and go on our website and get all the information about the show. Please make a difference to these veterans by coming aboard with us with Voices for Veterans. Thank you so much.
Could switching to Geico really save you 15% or more on car insurance? Do dogs chase cats?
Geico. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on...
You smell so good, I won't have to bathe the next 2 weeks.
Yay!
Anything. So, here, laugh a little harder. All right, yeah.
I will take him. I would be proud to show you off, you little old weirdo man.
Get a new sweater. The worst dressed man here tonight.
Right. Look, get that laugh. Get that laugh and get it in there tonight because nobody else is going to laugh like her. She's under drugs, all right?
Galaxy Luxury Coach is a full-service limousine and party bus company. Family-owned and operated, we are an industry leader with over 25 years of experience in providing best-in-class luxury transportation for your special event. Whether it's your precious wedding day, an all-day wine tour out east, your high school prom, that special birthday, or just an amazing night on the town, our professional chauffeurs stand ready to ensure your special event is truly special. Galaxy Luxury Coach has one of the largest and modern party bus fleets in the New York area. Our party buses are simply nightclubs on wheels, concert sound systems, light shows, lasers and strobes, multicolor LED lighting brilliantly lights your party bus inside and out. For corporate and more laid-back events, we will cater to your specific needs and requests. What sets Galaxy aside from all others in the luxury transportation industry is our attention to detail in customizing our services to your special event. At Galaxy, it's all about you and your guests. Galaxy customers return time and time again because they know they can trust Galaxy to help deliver those lifetime memorable moments. Step aboard and let your Galaxy experience begin.
Welcome to Formula Auto Wash, where every day is a great day for a car wash. Open 7 days a week from 8 a.m. to 5:30 p.m. Sundays, 8 a.m. to 4 p.m. Detailing packages for every budget, starting out at $29.99. 100% hand wash and detail center. Hog's hair and microfiber brushes and mitts. Proudly using Ecolab Blue Coral soaps and waxes. Formula Auto Wash has served the community for over 30 years. Senior discounts all day, every day. Ladies Day Wednesday, $3 off any wash. Early bird discount Monday through Thursday till 9:30 a.m. Check out our website, formulaautowash.com.
Really yucky.
Being a fireman is more than just putting out blazes and giving kittens CPR. Sometimes my duty demands I fan the flames, like when a call comes in from a lady who needs immediate assistance.
Maybe she needs help with a computer thing. Maybe she wants to go antique. Could be as simple as understanding that walking in heels is, it's hard.
Aussi simple que l'été dernier à Paris. C'est sympa.
Maybe it's ladies' night in, and she wants a simple, delicious recipe for margaritas with a twist. First, a can of limeade. Now hold on to this. You'll be using it. Side note, kittens make everything better. Next, add water. Now, a bottle of light beer. No, shh. Trust me, I'm a professional. And last, and most important, Sauza Blue Tequila. Now, mix it up. Ole. Yes, that's what I'm trained for. Whether it's to help her choose leggings or pants, telling her leggings are pants, or discussing leggings and jeggings versus pant pegging at her next ladies' night in, I'll come to the rescue. Don't call me a hero. Just call me. Let me know what time.
You smell so good, I won't have to bathe the next 2 weeks.
Yay!
Anything. So, here, laugh a little harder. All right, here. All
right. I will take him. I would be proud to show you off, you little old weirdo man.
Get a new sweater. The worst dressed man here tonight.
Right. Look, get that laugh. Get that laugh and get it in there tonight because nobody else is gonna laugh like her. She's under drugs, all right?
We are back in the madhouse on the Maverick Soul Hour. I am your host, Tommy Maher, and nothing gives me more pleasure than to get to introduce to the entire world, all 204 countries, one of my dearest friends and a fantastic artist, Mrs. Patti Greco Sunshine.
Thank you, Tommy. I'm so thrilled. I'm absolutely thrilled. Strike up the band.
Feeling love, that's all. That's enough for me. Yet I see.
It is such a pleasure to be here with Tommy Maher and Janine at Madhouse TV. I am just too excited, too excited.
I see faces covering up an empty eye, empty spaces where there used to be a soul inside. Nothing and no one ever thinks to you seems the wind could blow right through you. Believing in God that never knew you. I believe in love. I believe in love. And I believe in feeling good. And that is feeling love. Worry, light up your money tree. You got to hurry. Monkey do what monkey see. You're on a one-way street and you're speeding. Missing the signs you ought to be reading. Past the things you're late to be needed. I believe in love. I believe it. Nobody told me. Always knew it. Nobody sold me. I believe in someone to hold me. I believe in love. I believe in love. I knew. And I believe in feeling good. And that is feeling love. lonely. Sleeping in an empty bed shouldn't be only a place to rest my head. Cause I don't wanna find myself one day waking up and looking at Monday with some what's-his-name left from Sunday. I believe in love. I believe it, nobody told me. Always knew it, nobody sold me. I believe in someone to hold me. I believe in love. I believe in love. I do. And I believe in feeling good. Everybody should. I believe in feeling good. I believe in love. World. Hold it. This is a man's world, but it wouldn't be nothing, no, nothing without a woman or a girl. I want to do a song that, well, I love Barbara Streisand, you know that. The black, black widow is sitting in the middle of a web. It's the fly she seeks. It may be her lover, but you never wear a cover, cause she ain't had a bite for weeks. You think you're the same, cause you got the same name, but the widow has a mobile home. Remember what I told you, she got eight arms to hold you, and she's never gonna let you roam. She'll tuck you into bed, chuck on your head, then she'll wrap you as a midnight snack. Queen bee, baby, a friend that you may be left on your own. And nothing she'll give you gonna outlive you, but the queen bee is never gonna be alone. Longing for Atlantis, there'd been a praying mantis, and you know why he's on his knees. He may have religion, but he's just a sitting pigeon if a woman even starts to tease. He won't even quiver that she has a little nibble on his neck. What a way to go. But now you're gonna taunt it. She's been messing with a hornet. She's a blue-blooded wasp, you know. And just as you do it, she'll inject you with her fluid, and you ain't even got but none. Plate, not even first rate. She's gonna feed you to her seventh son. And just like the queen bee, baby, I pray that you may be left on your own. Oh, 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 oh. And nothing she'll give you gonna outlive you, but the queen bee is never gonna be alone. Oh, it's an optical illusion if you think that we're the weaker race. The man got the muscle, but the lady's got the hustle, and the truth is staring in your face. The mother bear squawks, the queen of the hawks is the one who gives home the bread. The lion that is regal and the bald-headed eagle need a woman just to keep them fed. But come the evening when I got a man is even inside the garden, hear the serpent say, when you're really into mating and there ain't no loving man around. Whoever wrote the story? When you're really into mating and there ain't no loving man around. Oh, throw out the glory, bring in the man. And there ain't no around. Give me them and I'll swing. Just write me a sequel, give me an equal. Oh, oh, oh. And I'm gonna give that man. I said I'm gonna give that loving man. I said I'm gonna give that loving man. I said I'm gonna give him that loving Thank you. Hey, check it out. We're going to be right back. Oof, got flustered.
Galaxy Luxury Coach is a full-service limousine and party bus company. Family-owned and operated, we are an industry leader with over 25 years of experience in providing best-in-class luxury transportation for your special event. Whether it's your precious wedding day, an all-day wine tour out east, your high school prom, that special birthday, or just an amazing night on the town, our professional chauffeurs stand ready to ensure your special event is truly special. Galaxy Luxury Coach has one of the largest and modern party bus fleets in the New York area. Our party buses are simply nightclubs on wheels, concert sound systems, light shows, lasers and strobes, multicolor LED lighting brilliantly lights your party bus inside and out. For corporate and more laid-back events, we will cater to your specific needs and requests. What sets Galaxy aside from all others in the luxury transportation industry is our attention to detail in customizing our services to your special event. At Galaxy, it's all about you and your guests. Galaxy customers return time and time again because they know they can trust Galaxy to help deliver those lifetime memorable moments. Step aboard and let your Galaxy experience begin.
Hello, I'm Dr. G. I've established an organization called Voices for Veterans. We use music to honor veterans and to help the public understand what veterans have gone through when they come home from war. On October 22nd of this year, we're going to have an incredible show, a 3.5-hour concert at Molloy College, one of the greatest 500-seat theaters on Long Island. We're going to honor 25 veterans. We've taken an incredible band, 15 people from Long Island, some of the best musicians we could find, and we merged it with a 30-person choir, merging gospel with rock and roll. This incredible 3.5-hour show is like none other that you've ever seen. This is Grammy quality. October 22nd, you can buy a ticket, you can make a donation, you can get involved, you can help us with the committee. You can look us up at v4veterans.org and go on our website and get all the information about the show. Please make a difference to these veterans by coming aboard with us with Voices for Veterans. Thank you so much.
Welcome to Formula Auto Wash, where every day is a great day for a car wash. Open 7 days a week from 8 a.m. to 5:30 p.m. Sundays, 8 a.m. to 4 p.m. Detailing packages for every budget, starting out at $29.99. 100% hand wash and detail center. Hogs hair and microfiber brushes and mitts. Proudly using Ecolab Blue Coral soaps and waxes. Formula Auto Wash has served the community for over 30 years. Senior discounts all day, every day. Ladies' Day Wednesday, $3 off any wash. Early bird discount Monday through Thursday till 9:30 a.m. Check out our website, formulaautowash.com.
Being a fireman is more than just putting out blazes and giving kittens CPR. It's
Sometimes my duty demands I fan the flames, like when a call comes in from a lady who needs immediate assistance. Maybe she needs help with a computer thing. Maybe she wants to go antique. Could be as simple as understanding that walking in heels is, it's hard.
Aussi simple que l'été dernier à Paris. C'est sympa.
Maybe it's ladies' night in, and she wants a simple, delicious recipe for margaritas with a twist. First, a can of limeade. Now hold on to this. You'll be using it. Side note, kittens make everything better. Next, add water. Now, a bottle of light beer. No, shh. Trust me, I'm a professional. And last, and most important, Sauza Blue Tequila. Now, mix it up. Ole. Yes, that's what I'm trained for. Whether it's to help her choose leggings or pants, telling her leggings are pants, or discussing leggings and jeggings versus pant pegging at her next ladies' night in, I'll come to the rescue. Don't call me a hero. Just call me. Let me know what time.
You smell so good, I won't have to bathe the next 2 weeks.
Yay!
Hey, laugh a little harder. Yeah. All right.
Welcome back. My name is Patti Greco Sunshine, and I'm thrilled to be here with Tommy Maher at Madhouse TV. I want to do a song for you that Tommy and I talked about our basement sessions that we did. This is one of the songs I did in the basement session, and Tommy said, is that song in your act? And I said, no. He said, well, it should be. So let's see what you think. I'm a jazzer at heart, and this is a Billie Holiday song. I hope you like it. Slave for you, I'll be a beggar or a knave for you. But if that is love, it's just going to have to do until the real thing comes along. I'd gladly move my love, dear, and is worth for you. But if that isn't love, it's just going to have to do until the real thing comes along. With all the words, just going to have to do until the real thing comes along. With all the words, dear, and my command, oh, I just can't
I just can't help you. I can't help you to understand. I'll always love you, darling. Come on, May, 'cause my heart is yours. Oh, 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 can I say I would lie for you? I'd cry for you. It's just going to have to do until that real thing comes along.
thank you. I love that. I love that song. I could be so comfortable in jazz. Hey, like my little shmata on my chair. I brought a little shmata. I'm going to move this back because I'm going to give you my Broadway debut right here. Woohoo! Hear me now, though I bleak and unbearable, thou art base and debauched as can be. With their knights, with their banner all bravely unfurled, now hurls down his gauntlet to thee. Am I Don Quixote, the Lord of La Mancha, destroyer of evil am I? Forever to conquer or die. Hear me, heathens and wizards and serpents of sin, all your dastardly doings are past. For the holy endeavor is now to begin, and virtue shall triumph at last. Am I Don Quixote, the Lord of La Mancha, my destiny calls and I go. Oh, the iron wheels of fortune will carry me onward, or whither, wherever they go. Whither, soever they blow, onward to glory again. My segment here with that was my vows, by the way. I ain't going anywhere. Not yet. You have to go to the wayward, darling. Yeah, that was my vows, but I want to right now Yeah, that's okay. Oh, here we are. This is it. Janine, darling, this is for you. I know you're a Barbra Streisand fan, and I've always loved Babs myself. Grew up with her. I hope you've enjoyed the show. This is what I love to do, and this is one of my favorite songs. Memories, let the corners of my mind, misty watercolor memories of the way we were, scattered pictures of the smile. We gave to one another for the way we were. It breathed, and it was all so simple then. Oh, as time rewrote every line, if we had the chance to do it all again, to leave. Could we memories maybe beautiful and yet what's too painful to remember? We simply just divide.
So what did I tell you? Come over here, my dear. I could not think of anything more fun and better to do than have one of my best friends here singing for the world, for the world. So it was my pleasure to introduce to the entire world my friend, Patti Greco Sunshine. And I also want to give out a shout out to her husband, Jonathan. We love you, man. Can't wait to see you. We got her. Don't worry about it. She's all right. We got her covered. So God bless everybody. Remember, May 28th, Washington Square Park, Blues for Peace. Be there. I will be emceeing. Come say hello. We got to change the world, everybody. It's time to end the hate and start the love, and we'll start it with some peace. So God bless you all. Have a great, blessed week. And my dear, thank you. It was so good having you here. I really mean it. Okay. Take care. Janine, thank you very much. You did an outstanding job once again.
Thank you. And Pat, thank you, darling.
And Pat. Pat.
We threw
Pat in, too.
I threw her in.
You're in, Pat. All right. Take care. Peace.